بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله أما بعد السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته my dear brothers and sisters in Islam and today inshallah we'll continue with the Sahaba radiallahu anhum ajma'in and today is a very special episode where the fitna is at the highest inshallah however we learn from our scholars that this fitna that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala kept us away physically we have to stay away from it verbally inshallah so this is the most important lesson for us brothers and sisters in this halaqa inshallah about Ali ibn Abi Talib radiyallahu anhu ardah and we cannot say enough about Imam Ali radiyallahu anhu an Ali al-Bayt al-Athhari ajma'in But we will talk about some of the facts today, inshallah, asking Allah subhanahu jalla fi ula to make us among those who listen to the speech and follow the best of it. Wa akhir da'wam. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, when we talked about Uthman ibn Affan radiallahu anhu arda, the last halaqa, we said that the fitna came in and it started with Abdullah ibn Saba, al-Mukanna ibn al-Aswad, alayhi min Allahi ma yastahiq. And remember this name because it will come back again, believe it or not. Whether we like it or not, the fitna started with him and again another fitna starts with him as you will see the two sides again come back to peace only to find the same man, Abdullah ibn Saba. Ibn al-Aswad, alayhi min Allahi ma yastahiq, coming back again to make sure that he actually puts more fitna on the plate of Ali radiallahu anhu wa ardah. And again, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, as we speak about Ali radiallahu anhu wa ardah, we will talk about the truth from the Quran and Sunnah and the authenticated hadith radiallahu anhum ajma'in from the Sahaba. So we will know what the truth is all about and we will not follow our whims and desires. We will not follow the hidden agendas. We will not follow the weak hadith. We will not follow the fabricated hadith. We will not follow the ones that we want to believe just because we want to have one side on the, over the other. And knowing for sure that Allah subhanahu wa jalla fi ulaha says, those two ta'ifa min al-mu'mineen iqtatala. Among the two firqas, the two types, The two teams of mu'mineen, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, call them true believers. And we will talk about the rest of the proof, inshallah, when we get there. However, let us take it one step at a time, but we don't have enough time to tell about Ali, about everything, radiyallahu anhu wa al-bayt ajma'in. Ali, radiyallahu anhu wa ardah, He was honored to be the first young man. And it was narrated, he was the first Muslim. Because if we go back in history, you'll find out that his father, Abu Talib, when he had too many children, he couldn't bear the burden of looking after them financially. So he asked for help for some of his family or the tribe to look after some of his children. Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu ardah, was lucky enough by the blessing of Allah subhanahu wa jalla fi ula to have Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam Rasulullah wa khatam al-anbiya wal mursaleen to have the honor to be in his home and be raised by him and taught by him subhanallah ya akhi so he was taught by Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam When their revelation came, he was in the house of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he was the first Muslim to become, and the first young man has that honor, Subhanak ya Rabb, to become a Muslim. So we know that Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu said a beautiful utterance. He says, "Muhammad al-Nabiyya akhi wa sihri." Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, akhi wa sihri. He is my brethren. And Sihri, because of the lineage, he married his daughter. Ali ibn Abi Talib married his daughter. So Sihr is from that. So we have to understand, brothers and sisters, if Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam had that honor and had Ali ibn Abi Talib had that honor, it's sufficient. But the poem keeps going. The poem says it's not just that. Muhammad al-Nabi, akhi wa Sihri, my brethren and my lineage. I married his daughter because that's the Sihr in that. Lineage. It's وَحَمْزَ سَيِّدُ الشُّهَدَاءَ عَمِّي Allahu Akbar. Wallahi, if we just don't go any more than this poem, it is sufficient to know about Ali, that he has that honor, that he cannot be combined in one man. So he says, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is my brethren, and I married his daughter, Sihri.
And Hamza, Sayyid al-Shuhada, Hamza radiallahu anhu arda, the master and the leaders of martyrs. Asadullah, the line of Allah subhanahu wa jalla fi ula. Hamza, ammi, he's my uncle. He says, wa Ja'far, alladhi yumsi wa yudhi. He's that Hamza, Ja'far ibn Abi Talib, al-Tayyar. He's known to be the one that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he went to the Mu'ta and his arm was cut, and the other arm was cut for the sake of Allah, he's holding the banner. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala replenished those arms with two wings of pearls is flowing in Jannah. So he says, the one that yumsi wa yudhi, is that the one that is flying al-Tayyar? That one is my brother. Allahu Akbar ya akhi. Look at the brethren, look at the brother, look at the uncle, look at the wife. Allahu musta'an. So look what, continuing it says, يَطِيرُ مَعَ الْمَلَائِكَةِ. He is flying with the angels. Ibn ummi, the son of my mother, meaning he means he's my brother. وَبِنْتَ مُحَمَّدًا, the daughter of Muhammad. Who? Fatima al-Zahra radiallahu anha, وَعَنْ أُمَّهَاتُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَعَنْ أَهْلِ الْبَيْتُ الْأَطْهَارِ أَجْمَعِينَ. سَكَنِي وَزَوْجِي. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala waja'ala minkum mawaddah wa rahmah. This second, this tranquility, this peace, home. Sakani wa zawji, is my wife. Manutu lahmiha bidami wa lahmi, his flesh is mixed with my flesh and my blood. Wa sibta ahmada, the grandchildren of Ahmad alayhi salatu wa salam, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Rasulullah. وصبت الحسن والحسين سيدا شباب أهل الجنة, the best of the children of the youth in heaven, carry the banner in heaven for the leaders of the youth. الحسن والحسين رضي الله عنهم وعن آل البيت أجمعين. He says صبت محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم, he is that grandchildren of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. He says ولدايا منها, my children are from her. الله أكبر. فأيكم له فهم كفهمي, who amongst you has this honor to have the understanding of the Quran and Sunnah more than I? Could anyone out there raise their hands as I? Wallahi Allah كذبت. Anyone? Allahu musta'an. Nasallahu al-afwa wal-afiya. So we now know, go back and find out what Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu did and said from the authentic ahadith and the truth, not the lying or what is bestowed or something that is belittled and to insult our intelligence to find out that that's what it is. And the narrations of history of those who have their own whims and desires, finding out what the truth is all about. Allahu Akbar. The truth, inshaAllah. We know that among the stories about Ali radiallahu anhu wa ardah is abundant. But it's sufficient for us to know the strength of Ali, the humbleness of Ali, the adl of Ali, the justice of Ali, the strength of Ali, the braveness of Ali, and the knowledge of Ali, and all of that among Ali radiallahu anhu wa ardah. It is sufficient for us to know that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Hisn Khaybar, the time where they were battling in Khaybar, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said he made a declaration. It's a beautiful declaration. He says, tomorrow, غَدًا سَأُعْتِ الرَّايَةَ, tomorrow I will give the banner for a man, يُحِبُّ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولُهُ وَيُحِبُّهُ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولُهُ, that man, he loves Allah and his messenger. And Allah and His Messenger love him back. Allahu Akbar. It is normal for us to love Allah and His Messenger, alayhi salatu wasalam. But it's not for everyone to know that Allah subhanahu wa jalla fi ula loves you back, or Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasalam loves you back. So when Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasalam says, I will give this banner tomorrow for someone that he loves Allah and His Messenger, it was normal among the Sahaba, radiallahu anhum ajma'een, that they all love Allah and His Messenger, alayhi salatu wasalam. But it was the second portion that the Sahaba now started to talk about. Who is that lucky man that Allah, subhanahu wa jalla fi ula, and Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam love him back? It is this time that Umar ibn Khattab, radiallahu anhu, said, wallahi ما تمنيت الإمارة إلا في ذاك اليوم. يومئذ, this is the only time, by Allah, I never asked or requested or wanted the imara before, except that day. Why? Because there's a declaration, there's a testimony from Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam that he will give this banner to a man that Allah loves and Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam loved back, because the first one is normal. Everyone does. But this is an honor. It's a badge that no one can have. You see? Now, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, at the time, in the morning, he looked. For whom? You guessed it? He was looking for Ali radiallahu anhu ardah. The night before, everybody was talking. Who do you think it would be? Who do you think it would be? So I hope it's me. I hope it's me. I hope it's me. Everyone was talking about it. This was the biggest news. So as Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is looking around the crowd, Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu ardah, he used to say, sort of stand up a bit or lengthen my neck so he can see me. Subhanallah. Looking for that badge, looking for that beautiful honor, the medal of honor. But Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, Aina Ali? Where is Ali radiallahu anhu ardah? They said he woke up with a little bit of a disease. His eyes are shut. He's bringing him to me. So even though he was ill, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, bring him to me. So he used his saliva, alayhi salatu wasalam, and wiped the eyes of Ali. By the blessing of Allah subhanahu wa jalla fi ula, he became cured right back, 100%. It says, خُذْ يَا عَلِي, take the banner Ali, وَقَاتِلِ النَّاسِ, and fight the people. His alama أُقَاتِلِ النَّاسِ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. And look at the beauty of the story. There's so many, you know, lessons to learn from the story. We'll take some of them, inshallah. And he says, take this and go fight the people and don't turn back. So now Ali took the banner and he literally took the commands of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he went. But he wanted to ask, what is he? So he didn't turn around. He's asking, what do I fight the people for? He's قاتل الناس حتى يشهدوا أن لا إله إلا الله. Fight people till they declare that they believe there's only one deity to be worshipped, deserving to be worshipped, that is Allah subhanahu wa jalla fi'ula, wa anni rasulullah alayhi salatu wasalam. And it's saying, and if they do, their blood is sacred, their wealth, their honor, everything is sacred. And of course, we have those people come in and fight, you know, the Orientalists and fight. So we give people a choice. At least, we know the truth about the Quran and the Sunnah, and there's oneness of God, and all the deviated sects before, or the ways of life or religions before, or the mistranslated or added or omitted or deleted scriptures before. So we say, we come, here's the true religion, complete Islam in full. After this, you make up your mind. You want to become a Muslim? Ahlan wa sahlan wa marhaba ya doktor. Right, Sheikh Bilal? طيب. After this, if not, then you can keep your own religion, but pay taxes. And of course, we know the rest, but it's not what most people think. And he says, وَاللَّهِ لَأَيْ يَهْدِيَ اللَّهُ بِكَ رَجُلٌ وَاحِدْ خَيْرٌ لَكَ مِنْ حُمَرِ النِّعَمِ. By Allah, if Allah uses you to guide one person, it is better for you than what? Than Humar al-Ni'am. Humar al-Ni'am is the red camels, literally translated. And Humar al-Ni'am, the red camels were supposed to be the highest and the biggest, the biggest of all, the most expensive camels, just like Cadillacs, Mercedes, BMWs, BMW, whatever. These type of modes of transportation, inshallah, you can relate to that. Okay? So it's the best of world possession. Another hadith says, مِمَّا طَلَعَتْ عَلَيْهِ الشَّمْسِ. Better for you to guide one person, better than whatever this earth has, whatever the sun rises upon, meaning this whole dunya, nothing. To guide one person is better than that, inshallah. So Ali ibn Abi Talib, he started declaring, Allahu Akbar, kharibat khaybar, inshallah. He declares, Allahu Akbar, kharibat khaybar, inshallah. And he starts to fight, and of course, you know, the people starting to say that I am so and I'm so. And Ali ibn Abi Talib says, "Sammatni ummi." He says, "There's a beautiful." He says, "Qad alim qad alimat Khaybar anni marhabu." This their king. He says, "Alim Khaybar, this place that they were fighting, Hisn, the fortress." Where the Jews were fighting behind, taking savage in, and he says that Anni Marhab, I am the who you know their Amir, whatever their king. Yusaki Salah Mujarrab, you know I am experienced in carrying the thing. إذا الحروب أقبلت تلهب, me that if the army comes in, I am on fire. الله مستعان هو في مشيئة الله أعلم anyway إذا الحروب قد أقبلت فنزل إلى علي علي بن أبي طالب خمسين says أنا الذي سمتني أمي حيدرة my mother called me among other names of a lion he says أنا I am the king of the jungle أنا so strong and أكيلهم بالسيف كالسندرة and I will take the sword and speaking of the sword علي رضي الله عنه وأرضاه الله أكبر it had two prongs and it was big and long it wasn't for anybody to be able to carry Abdul Faqar radiyallahu anhu warda and it was narrated ya akhi and ukhti Ali ibn Abi Talib radiyallahu anhu warda a strong fighter that he was it was narrated that some men tried to carry the hisn the gate that fell after And he couldn't, but Ali ibn Abi Talib carried it by himself. Allahu a'lam al-hujjah al-rawi. And some narration says that he used to actually carry this gate and use it as a shield. But now Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also wants to make sure Ali, you know, also learned the lesson, not to have anything in his mind. He came to him, talatham. He disguised himself one day. He says, come and fight me. There's a faris. There's a knight that's challenging you to fight. Behind this mountain, and after he fought, he beat Ali, Ali ibn Abi Talib رضي الله عنه وارضاه. But he says, "Astahlifuka billah an takshif, reveal yourself." It was Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, just to make sure he doesn't get, anything. Hasha, of course, among the best of creation, رضي الله عنه وارضاه. How could he? But Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم is also teaching humbleness. Humbleness, Ali ibn Abi Talib. Listen to his son, Muhammad ibn al-Hanifiyya, his son from another woman. Other than Fatima al-Zahra, radiallahu anhu wa ardaha. He says, Ya Abi, oh my father, who is the most beloved person to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? A man. He says, Abu Bakr. With no hesitation. That's what Ali ibn Abi Talib, radiallahu anhu wa ardaha, said to Prophet to Muhammad ibn al-Hanifiyya. So he says, then whom? He says, then Umar. So now Muhammad al-Hanifiyya knows he's going to go through the Khulafa. After this, he didn't want to take a chance. He says, "Thumma ant, then you." So Ali ibn Abi Talib, of course me, and so on. He says, "Ya bunay, innama ana rajul min al-Muslimin." Oh my child, oh my son, I'm another man. I'm just a man among Muslims. But that's his humbleness, radiallahu anhu warda. But he is Imam Ali, Amir al-Mu'mineen, radiallahu anhu warda, Khalifa al-Rabi' wal-Ashr al-Mubashara, wal Ahl al-Bayt, radiallahu anhu majma'in al-Athar. So you can see how Ali ibn Abi Talib, radiallahu anhu warda, how strong he was, how humble he was, how dedicated he was, how obedient to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam he was, and so on. But then you will find out that there is so much to share with you when it comes to that other, false and so on. In the hadith, he said that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam I believe it's in Tabuk. Some narration says Mu'tabar the truth is Tabuk. When Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was going to fight, and he says. Ali, you stay in Medina. Be my Khalifa in Medina. Look after Medina. So now the people that were not following Islam or the hypocrites are now saying, oh, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam only left Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu warda in Medina because he doesn't like him. He left him with women and children and the weak amongst us and the ill and the old people and so on. So Ali ibn Abi Talib got very angry. Then he started to wear the armors of war and he got his horse and fled to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And he caught up with the army and Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam looks back and he says, Ali, Ya Ali, أما استخلفتك في المدينة? Did I not put you as Khalifa in Medina? He says, Ya Rasulullah, أتستخلفني على النساء والصبيان? People are saying that you're doing this because you don't like me and you don't want my company, or you know, I'm among the hypocrites and the weak and the old and the women and the children. He says, Ya Ali, أما ترضى يا علي أن تكون مني بمنزلة هارون من موسى غير أنه لا نبي بعدي. So he says, Ya Ali, will you not be pleased to be to me that you are like Harun, Aaron, to Musa, Moses عليه السلام, as a brethren? غير أنه لا نبي بعدي. So people, if they have anything in the back of their mind, says there is no prophet or messenger after me. So you can understand now how Ali رضي الله عنه وارضاه was in the sight of Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. He says, in the history started be written down after Bani Umayyah. And in there are three categories. One, that they wanted to boast about Ali رضي الله عنه وارضاه in a way that actually not befitting. There was too much. And the other ones, he started to say now the other one, in order for us to raise Ali, we have to curse and even make the Sahaba kuffar. That was the extreme. And the third one was the righteous one, the modest, the missed the path with the Quran and Sunnah was their minhaj, and the truth was their declaration, inshaAllah. This fitna started with the killing of Uthman ibn Affan radiallahu anhu warda. And we talked about what happened in a previous episode. And it's sufficient for us to know that these people started with, remember the name, Abdullah ibn Sabah, when he came into Medina, he's starting to fish for faults and look for some weaknesses, starting to tell the people that Ali, Uthman ibn Affan came and took the wilayah from Ali, he's more deserving than so on. And, of course, when Uthman ibn Affan was actually told by the people around him that we will defend you, of course, as we talked about, he declined. Even though there were 700 people already, and they would have been able to fight him. But he says, no, I don't want any bloodshed among Muslims in my name, not to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fi'ala. And we talked about that he seen Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says that you were fasting, and you will break your fast with us tonight, and so on, as he was reading the Quran. But what we're talking about here now is another fitna. Believe it or not, after Uthman died, radiallahu anhu ardah, Medina had no emir for 5 days. And believe it or not, Ghasiqi, alayhim Allah ma yastahiq, the one that killed Uthman, he's the one that was the emir of Medina. Could you believe it? For 5 days. After, people started to recognize that we need an emir. So the majority of the people came, there's no one befitting for emir, except Ali radiallahu anhu warda. So they came up to Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu warda. He says, the wilaya is for you. You are most deserving of it now. And he actually refused it. But asarru, they were committed and they insisted that Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu warda to take the wilaya. After convincing and so on, and he knew that it's true, otherwise there would be a bigger fitna, he took the wilaya and he started to bay' al-muhajirin wal-ansar ajma'in. In Medina, he bay' al-muhajirin wal-ansar. In Medina. So al-muhajirin and the ansar gave the bay'ah, gave the covenant and to Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu warda. طيب. And then after this, دخل عليه طلحة والزبير. طلحة رضي الله عنه والزبير رضي الله عنه ورضاه وكبار الصحابة among the biggest of the صحابة came to Ali ibn Abi Talib رضي الله عنه ورضاه asking for the revenge. We need to kill those who killed the Uthman ibn Affan رضي الله عنه ورضاه. So Ali ibn Abi Talib heard him and he says, listen, there is about almost too many of them in Medina. How are we going to fight them? We need to use wisdom and give me some time. When this fitna goes out and we have the strength and the discipline and we are organized and we have one banner, then we can go get them. Not now. فاعتذر. He apologized that I will not be able to do it now. Then Talha was Zubayr and the Sahaba that came to ask for the revenge for the blood of Uthman radiallahu anhu warda, just to kill the people who killed him. When Ali ibn Abi Talib refused at this specific time, he wanted. But it wasn't out of the wisdom to do it now. And it's narrated that they actually gathered 10,000 from around. It's a big army. So they came out very angry that Ali ibn Abi Talib did not want to do it right now. And it was, of course, Ali was right. It was supposed to be to have a time and a hikmah to use it, inshallah. So now, when Muawiyah radiallahu anhu arda, in Sham, heard, he got very angry that Ali did not want to, radiallahu anhu, did not want to fight now. Especially when Naila, radiallahu anha, the wife of Uthman, radiallahu anhu, sent, because after she heard that Ali does not want to fight them now, he wanted to, but not now. You have to use hikmah, wisdom. So she sent the qamis, the shirt, or the thawb, the garment, that Uthman ibn Affan was wearing at the time, where he was stabbed 9 times in the chest and in the stomach and hit on the head with a Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. And the Quran was kicked. You can understand now the quality of the people that they were came and fight Uthman radiallahu anhu warda. Allahu Akbar ya akhi. Now, please understand that this is Uthman ibn Affan, Amir al-Mu'mineen at the time. His wife is the one that placed her hand to defend him, and they still cut her hand. So she sent her fingers. Naila sent the garment that Uthman was wearing, including the blood and the holes from the swords and the knives, to Muawiyah. Had the holes, the blood, and she put, including it, her own fingers that were cut, defending her own husband in honor of defending her husband. So when Muawiyah radiallahu anh saw that, he got angrier. And he placed the garment and the fingers attached on the pulpit of Masjid Dimashq. So people got extremely angry and they all came in on the bay'ah. They said, we agree, we are here to fight and kill those who killed Uthman ibn Affan. So please understand, they wanted to kill the killers of Uthman, and they gave the bay'ah to Muawiyah for the fighting, not the imara. I repeat, the people in Dimashq, in Sham, they gave the bay'ah to Muawiyah to fight and kill the killers of Uthman, not the bay'ah for imara. They were not giving him that he would be Amir al-Mu'mineen. It was Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu warda. So when that happens, people started to come around and they started to gather the people. Come in from the other places. Now the news has traveled to Mecca. The news has traveled to Mecca. And Talha al-Zubayr is starting to rally the troops. And the people from Mecca heard, and when Umm al-Mu'mineen, Aisha radiallahu anha wa ardaha, and Ummat al-Mu'mineen ajma'een, heard about the death of Uthman, she was very angry. And she started calling people to go fight the people who killed Uthman. Not to take Ali out or fight against Ali, but to go fight and kill the people who killed Uthman. Please understand, akhi and ukhti, there was nothing against Ali. They were after the people who killed Uthman ibn Affan, radiallahu anhu warda. So people started to say, Ya Umm al-Mu'mineen, O mother of true believers, we will follow you wherever you go. So she wanted to go and support Muawiyah to fight and kill the people who fought and killed Uthman ibn Affan. So people started to come to Basra to be close to Muawiyah radiallahu anhu warda. Now, when Muawiyah heard, he started to gather the troops, and now Ali ibn Abi Talib is hearing about it. When Ali ibn Abi Talib starts hearing about it, he actually said, I personally want to go ahead and fight with them in the beginning to get the revenge for Uthman ibn Affan. So it was no difference. Everyone wanted to fight to get the killers of Uthman ibn Affan. After this, he says, عَزِمَ أَن يَخْرُجْ بِنَفْسِهِ. He himself, he wanted to go to Al-Basra and join them. And this Abdullah ibn Salam radiallahu anhu, he stopped Ali ibn Abi Talib. And his son, Al-Hassan, stopped him. Abdullah ibn Salam radiallahu anhu and Sahaba Dajmain, he talked to Ali radiallahu anhu. He says, Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, la takhruj min al-Madinah. He says, do not leave Medina. فوالله إن خرجت من المدينة لا يعود سلطان الإسلام لبعدها بعد اليوم لها بعد اليوم. O Amir al-Mu'mineen, do not leave Medina. If you leave Medina now, the Sultan, this Imara, this the kingdom, and the head of the state of Muslims will not come back. It'll be difficult. So, but Ali ibn Abi Talib changed course. But he went out with 900 of the Sahaba radiallahu anhu majma'in. But when he was asked, even though people around him, they wanted to come and fight. But he said, no, we're going. We was asked, why are you coming? He said, للصلح, للإصلاح. إصلاح يا أخي. To reconcile our differences, to discuss this matter, not to fight. If he had 900 people, is that an army to go fight? It's not a big enough army to fight. But he was going to make sure that they, let's get the two sides together and talk about it, discuss it, and reconcile, find the solution. What is it all about? Let's talk about it. So he went out with 900 people. And he says, this is not an army that fights, wants to fight. It was a islah. So Ali ibn Abi Talib, when he went close by, he says, أسأل قعقاع ibn Amr radiallahu anhu warda. To talk to al-Mu'mineen. And he went actually to al-Mu'mineen Aisha radiallahu anhu warda. He says, يا al-Mu'mineen, السلام عليكي. ما جاء بك إلى هنا. Why did you come here? She said the same thing. Al islah. Now I know that is not. I'm not going to fight Ali. I want the people ajma'u to fight and to get together to fight the killers of Uthman. She said, but other than that, I'm here for islah. فقال القعقاع بن عمرو. He told أم المؤمنين رضي الله عنها وارضاها أحضري بطلحة والزبير أن كبار الصحابة. Oh, bring him. He says, listen. Ali ibn Abi Talib sent me to talk to you, radiallahu anhu warda, Amir al-Mu'mineen. He says, you want to kill the killers of Uthman. So do we. We want to kill the killers of Uthman. But if we do it now, we don't have the strength and the numbers to be able to fight this big army. But if you do it in Basra, the Basra of 6,000 people, will, if you kill them in Basra, they will, the people of those who will actually turn around and kill you. Do you think that is wise? He says, no. He says, do not do the same thing to us. فَلَا تَهْلِكُونَ. He says, use wisdom, be patient, and give Ali a chance to gather the troops and have this Imara first settled, and then we can have one time and do it. فاقتنعا, it made sense. They were convinced that it will give him time, and we will wait till it's right time and go fight those who killed Uthman ibn Affan radiallahu anhu warda. Okay. He said after that, in the night before, both sides were convinced that we will reconcile. We will come back and make sure that we will wait and give them time. So Fabata, the two groups, they went to sleep in the best mood. They were very happy. Very happy that they're not going to fight or whatever. We'll give the time. But who was not happy? The other side, mean not the two believers, groups of believers, but the hypocrites, Abdullah ibn Saba and his dogs, Abdullah ibn Saba and his army, عليهم من الله ما يستحق. He says, والله علي بن أبي طالب أعلم الناس بكتاب الله. He says that he is the smartest of them, of the book of Allah and the Sunnah of Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, and he would rally the troops and he will know the truth and he would be able to get us back. So he says, we cannot do that. If it reaches that, لَنَفْعَلَنَّ بِعَلِي مَا فَعَلْنَا بِعُثْمَانِ. Allahu Akbar. If it reaches that point, we will do to Ali what we done to Uthman. So were they after Ali? They were given Ali the Imara? No. They were after they destroy the Imara of Muslimin, of Mu'mins. And they destroy these are the hypocrites that come within us and destroy us from within. Now the truth is revealed. Abdullah ibn Saba, he says, if it came to this, Ali wants to fight us, we will go back. He wants to fight those who killed Uthman. We will go back and kill him like we killed Uthman. So were they after giving the Imara to Ali? They should have submitted. No, but it wasn't that. They said, we will go back and kill him like we killed Uthman. Allahu Akbar ya akhi. The truth is revealed. So what happens? He now rallies the troop. He says, if we let them off the hook tonight, we will be doomed. The two groups will come and united after, and they will come and kill us for sure. However, they betrayed the covenant. Who? Abdullah ibn Saba and his group. How? At night time, where both sides are asleep, Everyone agreed. Everyone, alhamdulillah, was content with the argument. They started killing both sides. So each side thought that was a betrayal from the other side. So they started to fight each other. Allahu Akbar. They started fighting each other. And as the fight came in, up and running so fast, it came down so fast. Walhamdulillah. And Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu himself, went to Umm al-Mu'mineen Aisha radiallahu anha wardaha. He says, As-salamu alayki ya Umm al-Mu'mineen, kayfa haluki? Peace and blessings be upon you, Umm al-Mu'mineen. How are you? غَفَرَ اللَّهُ لَكِ. May Allah forgive you. But the intention was not to fight Ali. Was the intention, I repeat, the intention was to fight, kill the killers of Uthman. Because both of them, they were actually declaring, we want to kill the Qatalat Ali. Both sides were declaring and saying the same utterance. قَاتَلَ اللَّهُ قَتَلَتْ عَلِي. May Allah rage war on those who killed the killers of Uthman. Uthman. Radiallahu anhu. So you can understand how things start from just a rumor or one that does not yataharra. إِن جَاءَكُمْ فَاسِقٌ بِنَبَإٍ فَتَبَيَّنُوا. The fasiq kharaja an ta'atillah aw amrillah. The one that comes out of the obedience of Allah. If someone comes to tell you something, تَبَيَّنْ تَحَرَّى يَا أَخِي. Calm down. Use wisdom. This is a grave matter. We don't just haphazardly go and follow rumors without looking into the matter, making sure that we do the right thing and look into it and be just and fair. So now he goes to Umm al-Mu'mineen radiallahu anha and he says the greetings and says, غَفَرَ اللَّهُ لَكِ. غَفَرَ اللَّهُ لَكِ. And he says, Muhammad ibn Abi Bakr ila Makkah. And he sent with her a person to take her safely to make sure she goes back to Mecca because she was actually going to perform Hajj. After this, another fitna وَالْعِيَذُ بِاللَّهِ وَلَا حَوْلَ وَلَا قُوَّةَ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ came in at the time of Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu ardah once again. He sent to Muawiyah in al-Sham يَطْلُبُ الْبَيْعَ. He's asking for the bay'ah, radiallahu anhu arda. So Muawiyah said, I will give you the bay'ah. But people here want to make sure that you fight the people of, they still see the blood and the garment and the holes and the fingers of Na'ila. They still want to go after the people that killed Uthman ibn Affan, radiallahu anhu arda. And Ali ibn Abi Talib said, I will, but later. The people did not heed. So Muawiyah at that time, he refused at that time. So as you see, that Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu arda sent to Muawiyah radiallahu anhu Abu Musa al-Ash'ari radiallahu anhu, and Muawiyah chose Amr ibn al-As radiallahu anhu arda. And please understand that they said, Nuhakkim kitabullah. They will take the Quran as the judge. They both agreed. But all this khuza'balat wal khurafat, all this legend and histories that you read in the books, it should have been nothing but filed under G. Those people want to make some movies, they want to make some money, and they just want to sell, if it bleeds, it leads type of thing. And it says that lying, that Muawiyah sent Umar radiallahu anhu, and Ali sent Abu Musa al-Ash'ari, and they both thought that they will kill both one and will, Allahu Akbar, what kind of nonsense is this? When Muawiyah said, okay, nakhla'hum both, and then kill them, we will take them both out of the Imara, then we have a new Amir. One man says, I will take Ali out, and Umar ibn al-As says, okay, I take out Ali and I thabbit Muawiyah. What kind of nonsense is this? These are the Sahaba radiallahu anhum ajma'in. Allahu Akbar ya akhi. And remember, this is the same man that says, in al-hukmu illa lillah. Who said it? Listen again, when people misuse the Quran, have a hidden agenda, Allahu Akbar. And he says, إِنِ الْحُكْمُ إِلَّا لِلَّهِ. Imagine, my brothers and sisters, the man that says, إِنِ الْحُكْمُ إِلَّا لِلَّهِ, Abdullah ibn Saba, ibn al-Aswad, عليه من الله ما يستحق. He says that the ruling is only for Allah. Ali ibn Abi Talib says, كلمة حق يريد بها باطل. يراد بها باطل. This word is truth. It's the word of Allah. الحكم is for Allah subhanahu wa jalla fi ulah. But he says, what intended for was باطل, falsehood, lies. He wanted to start a fitna. You can understand when they discuss this issue. He says, "Inna kitabillah." And he says, "If you make something that is unlawful, this is ulil amr among them, a wise man or a person that is a ruler from you. And then he will tell you if you killed something in the haram or even hajj, that he will tell you what to, like a rabbit or something, and as an expiation. So if you kill, imagine." An animal. Do you think from a curled one person you're going to destroy all the Muslim ummah? And he says, who amongst you wanted to fight the other side? And who amongst you wanted to take Umm al-Mu'mineen Aisha? Yes, be Aisha. Who wants to take Umm al-Mu'mineen, the wife of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, your mother, as according to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, who wants to take her as Sabi? Malik al-Yameen, the owner as your right hand possesses, and take her as a slave. Are you kidding me? So you can understand now the fitna that Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu ardah. And again, I repeat, it is sufficient for us that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called them, وَإِنْ طَائِفَتَانِ مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ اقْتَتَلَ. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called them in Surah Al-Hujurat, those two groups of believers fought. They were not disbelievers, ya akhi. So how can we say nukafir? Allah help you, wallahi. And it is true that Prophet Muhammad sallam says, yaqtuluka, this Ammar ibn Yasir radiallahu anhu arda, and the Sahaba ajma'in, al-fi'a al-zalima. Muawiyah radiallahu anhu was very kayyis and fatin. He says, they brought him, yes, they killed him. I mean, yes, they're human beings. Human beings. But the people now, Talha Zubayr i'tazala, they knew that al-haq ma' Ali. The truth is with Ali. So they left. They didn't want to fight. So when people came up to Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu arda, says, Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, why is fitan isn't too much in your time? And it wasn't at the time of Abu Bakr or Umar, and started just in the end of time of Uthman. He said, because the people were with Abu Bakr and Umar radiallahu anhu arda was like Uthman ibn Affan and myself. But the time of Uthman ibn Affan and radiallahu anhu arda and myself, we have people like you. Hypocrites started to come in, people started to, the weakness of faith and all of that stuff started, and that's when we start to lose it. Anyway, brothers and sisters, I repeat, this is a fitna that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala pardoned us from it. Physically. We were not there, alhamdulillah. Even he says that this is fitna, i'tazil. Even be Abdullah al-Maqtul, don't fight if you're not sure what it is. Who is a Muslim, who is not. When even the Sahaba says, go fight, he says, give me a sword that tells me who is a true believer and who is not, or who is a hypocrite. Radiallahu anhum ajma'in. Tayyib. And Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu ardah did his best to put out this fitna. And unfortunately, it wasn't to be. However, we know that Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu ardah that mentioned that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, Wallahi ya Fatima. Because Fatima, one time she was upset with Ali radiallahu anhu arda, and actually he left Fatima. Forgive me, it's a bit draining to go back in history and find this painful part of our history. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have mercy upon us all. Radiallahu anhu ajma'in. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu arda, when Fatima was angry with him and he went to sleep outside and he goes back to wake Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu arda up, and he says, Qum ya Aba Turab, Qum ya Aba Turab, meaning wake up
or owner of dust, meaning he was sleeping on the ground. And he told Fatima, Ya Fatima, radiallahu anha wardaha, is wallahi ya Fatima, law lam yukhlaq Ali, la ma wajadna laki kuf'an min al-rijal. Wallahi ya Fatima, if Ali was not created, radiallahu anhu wardaha, we would not have found a man to be befitting for you. We'll continue, inshallah, some other time. Subhanakallahumma bihamdika, nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.